Mocha is a Y Combinator-backed company that lets you use AI to build websites and web apps. Something great about Mocha is the database and backend and user authentication are all built into the one platform. Their goal is to build the easiest possible AI website builder for people who are non-technical. But is it really easy to use, and are the results actually good? In this video, we're going to use Mocha to build an all-in-one website for local service, including a form, map, and built-in CRM and calendar. The last feature we add in the admin portal really surprised me, so you're going to want to stick around. Thank you to Mocha for sponsoring this video. Click the link in the description to try Mocha out for free and build alongside me. Let's jump in. Here we are in Mocha, and the prompt we're going to use is to build an all-in-one business website for a local cleaning company in San Francisco. It should have a contact form for leads, a map of the service area, and a backend calendar to manage clients. So we're going to send that off. And just a reminder to click the link in the description to try Mocha out for yourself and build alongside me. So here we are in the Mocha editor. Now on the top of Mocha, we have a few different tabs. On the build tab, you have the left side chat, which is similar to other tools that you may have seen for AI building. And then on the right side, you can see the preview once the app is generated. We have the code tab to actually view the code that is generated. There's a data tab to view the actual data that's saved in our database. So for our use case, we're going to save our leads here in the database. And then there's additional settings to go through, including the project name, a share preview so you can update what it looks like when you share your app on social media. There's assets, publishing to add your own custom domain, Google sign in, and you can connect your own Google account so that your own brand will show up for sign in. There's a knowledge base as well for adding your own knowledge that you want the AI assistant to know for every prompt. This could be, just as an example, following your own brand voice for writing copy on your website. Something that's really nice about Mocha is that everything is integrated into the app, so you don't have to integrate any other tools. We have our database and logic all built in to one platform. And at the end of the video, I'd love if you left a comment to let me know if you think using Mocha is better than using something like Squarespace for this type of app, especially considering all of the features we're going to build in custom. First draft is done. We have a modern website where it's displaying the services. We have a map, which we asked for here in San Francisco. And it looks like it basically created this area, which is nice to have a circle around the service area. We have a form for getting a free quote. We'll test that out shortly so we can make sure that it works. And then it also created a simple footer. Now, it also says it created an admin section with Google authentication, and our customers can request quotes through the contact form, and we can track and manage the leads through the backend calendar. So we're going to test out the backend calendar shortly. But first, why don't we publish this app and see what it looks like live? So to publish an app in Mocha, all you have to do is go to the top right and click Publish App. Really impressed that it was able to do all of this in one prompt, one initial prompt. Mocha does a good job in the back end of breaking everything down step by step and just building one feature at a time for us. App is live on this URL. Now, as I mentioned before, you can add your own custom domain, which we would want to do if this was a real website. But in this sample, we're just going to use Mocha's URL. So here, let's scroll down. And it says, get your free quote. So let's enter in our information. Okay, so I'm gonna click get free quote. It says, thank you, we've received your request. We'll contact you within 24 hours to schedule your cleaning service. All right, great, and I can click submit another request. So that part worked, at least in terms of submitting the request. Let's go back to our database just to see if it was added. I'm just gonna refresh to make sure that it is updated. And if we go to the top left, you need to switch from your development database to your production database, because production is where you'll see the data from our live app. And if we go to leads, I can see here, we have the lead came in for our service, which is great. So I'm just gonna ask a question now to the AI to say, as an admin, how do I view the leads? Because, so it's saying, I just need to go to /admin. And the other thing I'm gonna ask is, how do you know what account should have access? Because I didn't set an admin account or anything. So let's see what it says. And by doing this in discuss mode, we can chat with the AI assistant without actually writing code. Basically, right now it's saying as long as they log in, they're going to have access. So what I'm going to say is turn off discuss mode and say, let's hard code in only giving set.nocode.mba access as an admin. So you can build that into your app. And there are other ways to do this that you could ask the AI assistant to do, but this is just the way I'm going to do it in this demo. Okay, so now I'm just going to go ahead and publish up here and publish the app to make sure that the code that we wrote in development is going to publish live. And now here I am on just the slash admin page. So let's sign in with Google. First, I'm going to sign in with a different email address to see if it doesn't let me access. Okay, perfect. With my personal email, it says access denied. So let me sign out and then try again with the correct email. It worked perfectly. We have a pending lead and it built all of this. This was all behind the scenes and I'm really actually excited that it was able to build this out. So here we have our leads and it looks like we also have an appointment calendar that's built into our admin as well. And then it's almost like a CRM that it's created because it's given me the ability to mark it as completed. I can also mark as pending, mark as contact. So you can go back and forth and you basically will have this CRM of leads and whether you've contacted them. And we could also build in additional features to actually contact them and actually have the ability to write an email and contact them all through the app. There's a lot that you can do with Mocha. This is just like scraping the surface of what's possible. Now let's just test out the appointment feature. We have an appointment. We can create the name, email, phone, put it in and create the appointment. But what I want to do actually is, this is a really easy additional feature to make. Let's say we have a lead and we want to convert that to an appointment. So I like this ability to have a new appointment. Maybe you need that sometimes, but let's say we want to convert a lead to an appointment. Just sending a prompt that I want the ability in the admin page to turn a lead into an appointment. So I don't need to enter in all their info since we already have it. So this is just one example of how we can start to build on top of what Mocha built in the first version as you test it and come up with new ideas. And then let's just go ahead and publish it. Now we could also test it in development, but I'm just going to publish it and test it live. And now there's a button added called convert. So I'm going to click that. And now we're in the appointment setting page, but it's pre-filled the name, email, phone number, service type, which is awesome. So let's just go ahead and add it at a date and time just to test this out. We can put it at scheduled and let's go ahead and create the appointment. Now we have the appointment as scheduled. We can edit it, change it to completed, for example. So there's all sorts of things we can do here. And then if I refresh the page, it'll show up as completed and not pending. So it's cool that this is all built into the backend. So this is what I think separates Mocha from like Squarespace. So we built our website. Of course, we can fully customize that with AI. We also built this full backend and CRM and calendar into our app. So it's not just a website, it's a whole business management system that you have full control over with the AI to continue improving and making updates to. And there's so many things I can think of to add to this. Just as an example, we could add like a multi-step lead form that's almost like a quiz to find out how much it's going to cost so we can improve potentially the conversion on this. So there's just so many ideas that you could build. I hope that you enjoyed this. Click the link in the description to go to Mocha yourself. There's a free plan so you can start building today without paying anything. And if you have any questions at all, leave a comment below. And if there's anything you want to see build in Mocha, let me know in the comments as well, and maybe I'll use that as a future video. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free AI content like this, and we'll see you in the next video.